So that one was when we were doing the pox out and coming through and drawing down here. So when he is down there, I'm either attacking the Achilles, which is, if you see here, really, really in a vulnerable spot. It hurts a lot, even during training and when we're sparring. You can't do this very hard because they're gonna feel this. So I come through here, I'm gonna step through. My motion on this takedown, first we come back up, when I get through here and I do my pox or he's punched me and I parry it, and I go through and I draw him out, and I come down through here. This hand will come through, grab the head. If I have hair, I take the hair. If not, I get up underneath the jaw, I hit the back of the head. So I'm pulling him into the strike, clearing the path for the body. Now, he's pretty big, so I either step back and cause him more pain and drive this elbow through here, or I stay where I'm at and just go with a side shear and then come back and again work some more elbows. So we've come through here, we've struck, now we're in this position. I pull, I hit, I clear, and I strike, or I strike. I can step back. So if I don't step back, like that, then I go in this direction and I aim my attacks in there. I can also pull open the arm, that sort of thing. Drop down with it. There's a lot of things in this area. If I open this up, and it's uncomfortable to sit in here. But if I open this up, I bring that down as a good strike and continue with that. And then you can fold over onto the head. There's lots of things you can play with. The other thing that we stick and play with is when I'm coming through here like this, again, I want to change his base. We're looking at how I can defeat his base. If I was smaller, I would be compact enough to already be in this position where I could just take my elbow, not at the low floating rib, but there's a few pain centers that we touch upon during grappling with this. We make people feel pain so they are desensitized to it in training. And my method for actually working the takedown is a lunge step toward the outside of his base, and then I work that control. So I combine that from here, this motion, getting back into the lunge step. I can assist if I want to here. If I'm taller, I'm gonna go here, and then I'm gonna come up with the elbow like this. We have a specific technique for using this particular elbow in other areas. But this will do damage, but it also, if you see the angle that I'm creating this, I'm gonna keep that going because that tilts him on that base. Got his third point of his triangle. If you look back at our Wing Chun videos, I'm tilting him up toward the third point of his base, and then I'm gonna step in. I own that position. So all of this is about owning this position. And when you got headgear on, you can actually go full shoulder shots, create this base, this change in position, come down with strikes and work that. You can also work coming through here, you clear this space just enough to slam your elbow onto the thigh. My body actually drops, my hip comes down, and I put all of my momentum in the shot. I can also come up, again, sapu, and take the leg while I've done that. So not only is he hurt on the thigh because of my coming through like this, but I'll sapu, give you a little less pressure on that point. But I drive it through here. Now I'm set up for this sapu. And I take it, go from there, just come back to here, all of that cool stuff.